Hey folks, Mark Devine here, coming at you from SEALFIT headquarters with the latest edition of SEALFIT TV. Today we're going to talk about visualization basics. Now visualization is near and dear to my heart. It's been part of my training for years. Helped me become a Navy SEAL, helped me get through, become honor man in my class, has helped me in business, helps me perform at all levels. It's an extraordinarily valuable skill to develop. And it's one of the cornerstones of our Unbeatable Mind program, okay? And so I want to give you a few thoughts and tips on how to develop a visualization practice. First, there's really two types of visualization, or two ways that we use visualization. There's more than this, but these are the two primary for athletes and leaders. First is what we call a rehearsal visualization. Now, this is when you want to perform a skill, you know, to a level of perfection. Well, then in our mind's eye, we can practice it with that perfection, and our physiology will accept the practice at a very subtle level, so that when we show up to do the actual event in our body, so to speak, you know, our performance will improve. And so the more you practice the visualization, the more or the better the performance will get in the outside world. And so there's really there's a lot more to it than that, but that's, you know, kind of at the nuts and bolts level what a performance or a rehearsal visualization is. Second is what I will call an idealized state visualization. And this is what, you know, some would call manifestation, or what I've referred to as also a future me state. So this is where you'll envision an ideal state for yourself at some point in the future. Like if you're working on becoming a leader, a master authentic leader, then you can envision yourself performing in the context of being, right? Not performing an event, but being that person, you know, interacting with people authentically, you know, making decisive calls that are spot on, being calm in the face of, you know, danger and chaos. I mean, being the type of person. So you see yourself as that person, and that imagery starts to take root, and it really gives you a lot of confidence, and it gives you momentum toward that state, okay? And so when you do that second one, it's going to be also a long-term project, and think in terms of months or years, right, instead of days or weeks, all right? Additionally, you know, the last point I'll make here on this in terms of what it is, you can use visualization to immediately change your physiology in a training or a difficult situation. That's a different subject, really. That is in the realm of mental toughness, but it just shows you how vast this topic of visualization is. Okay, so real quick, how do we start a visualization practice? Let's just focus on a rehearsal visualization for now. First, you need a baseline image of what it is like to perform at the level that you'd like to, right? You can't just go in without any reference point and start visualizing perfect double unders, let's say. Obviously, you need to observe perfect double unders, right? So the baseline is a video, or observing someone else who's got, you know, perfect form that you want to emulate. And so find that person that you want to emulate, or that, you know, the athlete, or this works as well for, you know, great leaders. Find that person you want to emulate and get, you know, watch a video, read the book, you know, really get a good internal representation of what it would look like for somebody else. And then what we do is with that image in our head, we manipulate it and replace ourselves into that picture. So literally place, you know, the picture of yourself, the image, the feeling, and you can do that from a first or a third person perspective. First person is like in the imagery looking out of your eyes. Third person would be like you got a helmet, you know, you're actually seeing yourself. The first would be, you know, helmet cam. The second would be you're seeing yourself in the image, right? I hope that's clear. If it's not, then call me. Finally, we want to add some juice. This next part is really important. So the juice is, I've got the mental imagery clear, and now I want to energize it. I want to energize it with sensations, emotions, with color, with sound, you know, everything that you can bring to bear that's going to make that, you know, that imagery like really, really pop and be powerful for you. And then the last thing is what you'll do is anchor this into your physiology and your psychology through repeated practice, through triggers, okay? Anchor triggers, and by really deep emotionality, right? And so, you know, we can represent what's happening in the imagery to something else in our life. So those are advanced practices that we get into in Unbeatable Mind. But for now, there you go. That's a good overview of visualization. Put it to work in your life, and I will check in with you next time. Hoo-yah.